Hey guys, I'm going on this big Germany trip and it's gonna include a lot of pack, a lot of new credits for me, and I'm just so excited for the whole trip in general. But this video will be my top 10 most anticipated coasters that I'm going to ride on the trip. So it's not the 10 best coasters by any means, it's just the 10 that I'm looking most forward to ride. At number 10 spot, I have Wilde Hilde, or however you pronounce that. That coaster looks so unique. It doesn't look that good at all. It kind of looks like an in sorry, an family version of the Intamin Saxspan. But yeah, just because of the uniqueness, I included this on the list. Number 9, I have at number 9 I have Skywheel at Skyline Park. So this is another one of those that just here because of how unique it is and how weird it is. This looks decently fun, not anything too special, but it just looks fun, and I'm just curious to check it out. And that lift hill looks actually pretty scary, even for me. So yeah, I'm curious to check this out. Number 8, I have Freischutz. This one has mixed reviews. Some people say it has a great layout, stuff like that, but it should be rough. But it have lap bars only, so I'm not sure if I mind the roughness that much at all. But yeah, time will show me. But I definitely think the layout looks great and it looks well paced and stuff like that. So it looks like a good coaster, but I will see how it rides. At number 7, I have Sky Scream. So this is here because I'm so excited to check out a Skyrocket 2. And they look great. They look like great fun rides with good hang time and pretty forceful and just good fun. The drops, the twisted drops looks fun. It has a non-inverting loop, probably not the most powerful of them, but it looks fun. It definitely looks like a fun ride. And this one have lap bars, which means it's one of the better ones, and a really themed queue line. So probably the best Skyrocket 2 in the world. Next up at number 6 spot, I have Van Helsing's Factory. This ride looks really interesting. It's a Goslar bobsled, and I love these kind of rides. And this is one of the smaller ones of them. It's actually maybe even the smallest. And it doesn't go that fast at all, and it isn't that tall at all. But it is really well themed. It's an indoor coaster, and it looks interesting. It looks fun, but I'm just so curious to ride it because I've heard amazing reviews about it, which is interesting. So yeah, I'm looking forward to see if it is as good as people say it is, or if it's as overhyped as I probably think it is, or at least what I could imagine. Now we go down to the really good ones. At number 5, I put Dynamite at Fehmarnbelt Pond. So this is the second Mack Big Dipper in the world. And I don't think it looks as good as Lost Gravity, but it still looks like a really fun ride. It looks like one of the most forceful Mack coasters. And it looks to have a fun, interesting, but short layout. The Wingo Drop looks pretty fun. It looks to give some good hang time. And it has some unique elements, like the vertical loop. I never thought they would put a vertical loop on a Mack Big Dipper, but they do. So just a really fun looking ride that I'm curious to check out. Number 4, I have Star Trek at the movie park. So I love these Mack launch coasters, and this one looks like a really good one of them. It has 3 launches, which looks they all looks really weak. It's not the launches that I'm excited for, but I'm excited for the elements on this one. The spike, the vertical spike, and the top hat. Some of the inversions looks really fun, and it looks to give a lot of airtime as well. And it's really well themed. I've heard that, and it looks really well themed as well. So I'm just really excited for this one. Number 3 is El Toro at Fehmarnbelt Pond. So yeah, this one is ahead of Dynamite for me because I wanted to ride this for so long since I first saw the POV of it, I thought that, yeah, I need to ride this someday. And This day is soon now, and I'm so excited to ride it. Looks to have a lot of airtime. Looks like one of the better GCRs, I will say that. So I'm excited to see if it is that. Yeah, whatever it is. At number two, I have Carajo, or Carajo, or however you pronounce it. This one looks so much fun. I love these Gerslauer launch coasters. Yeah, I've only ridden Lynet in Vorup Sommerland, and also the launch Girofighter Flug for Norgård. But this one is a Infinity launch coaster, so a different model from Gerslauer. It's the same model as Wurters Cannon, and this one just looks so fun. It looks to have a lot of great elements, a lot of airtime, a lot of hang time, and some different, a lot of different kind of elements. Some weird theming as well, by the looks of animatronic, and yeah, relatively intense probably since it's Gerslauer. Let's move on to the number one spot, which is miles ahead of all the other coasters on this list. I'm so excited to check it out. It's Expedition G-Force at Holiday Park. So I've wanted to ride this since forever, and it is probably so far my most anticipated coaster that I'm going to ride, and it's just going to be amazing. I'm so excited to check it out. I don't have too high hopes for it because I don't want to be too disappointed. I've heard some people say it's really overrated, so I go in with pretty low expectations, but I am still so excited to finally ride this one. That has been all for this video. I'm just in general really, really excited for the trip. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye guys.